been thinking way too much, and I'm way too gonna drive. I got anger in my chest, I got milkings on my mind, and you didn't fit the picture, so I guess you want the vibe. I've been rolling on the freeway, I've been riding 85. I've been thinking way too much, and I'm way too gonna drive. I got anger in my chest, I got milkings on my mind, and you didn't fit the...
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to Madden 18 on EA Sports. Today's matchup features the top scoring pass offense of the NFL. The Packers are top 10 in passing TDs, and they'll go against the Saints, who are very aware of what they'll be dealing with.
We are at the oldest continually operating stadium in the NFL as you get a look inside Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. We all know this community lives for its Packers, and the green and gold came out of the tunnel a short time ago, and it was loud. We are ready for football, so are they, as the Packers get set to match up with Drew Brees and the New Orleans Saints. Now on first down. Caught left side by Cobb. And he'll take this forward for two, maybe three. But we do have a flag down, and they're already marching backward. With a give, it's Aaron Jones, and not much there at all. He's up only to about the 16-yard line. Now it looks like we'll get a timeout, and we will. We've got an injured Packer on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. From the gun, it's Rodgers. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down. This defense looking for an early stop. This is third down and six. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Cameron Jordan. He's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of five, and it'll bring up fourth down. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And he goes out right around the 39. It's a 40-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. Off to his fullback, and getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
Left. You're good. You're good. You're good. You're good.
ground. This is Isaiah Crowell. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
8 yards to go here on second down. And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Now Brees throwing on second down. He's got a man. It's his fullback. Call it a gain of 3, and that'll bring up a third down. So here we go, a third down after the second down pass completion. Throw, it's Breeze. Looking for Snead, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Michigan man, Jake Ryan. And a return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line. That's now a second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. So after the INT, it's Rodgers. Uncorks one for Davis. A swing pass caught. It's a big play there for Green Bay. 53 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. They'll run it with Williams. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Green Bay touchdown. A great play there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Packers have taken the early lead. And he knocks it through. Crosby on now to kick it away. On the return, it's Ted Ginn Jr. A big hit. Knocked down sideways. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. That's a matchup maybe they go back to their outer third of the field as this game continues.
Yeah, I think back to my high school coach, John Ford. He used to say when we got big plays early in a game or good plays, he'd always say, foul it away, lad, foul it away, because he'd want to come back to it later in a key situation. It may come back to this one a little more often than that.
Didn't he say laddie or did he say lad?
Yeah, it just depended on what he was feeling at the moment.
Okay, I thought that was the guy you told me about that used to say laddie a lot.
Laddie, when you heard laddie, he was usually in a pretty good mood. Lad,
We've seen quite a bit of the short passing game here early on first quarter, haven't we?
We have, and I think it works a couple of ways for this team because, number one, you throw the short game until they stop it. And if they're not going to stop it, you keep throwing it, and occasionally you'll break a tackle and turn into a bigger gain. Also, if they start to creep up, start to pressure receivers, now you go over the top, take it deep, and now you get some of those big shots downfield.
Breeze to throw on second down. Now Breeze lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
They'll try to run for it with Cornell. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. He lost two, and it brings up fourth. Now the ninth-year man from LSU, Thomas Morstead, on to punt, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. This is fielded at the seven. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. An update from a game going on in Indianapolis. The Jaguars extending their lead to a couple of touchdowns now. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. A first carry here for Ty Montgomery. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Second down. And incomplete on the deep ball. Randall Cobb, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
Well, partner, I guess that answers the question about whether they're going to sit on it or not.
It does. Now we'll see if they try that again.
Yeah, I think what we find on plays like that, when you take that shot, if you're unsuccessful, then you go way more conservative to finish the half, you know? I think that's the way they'll go.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Uncorks one for Davis. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they've managed to get it done.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. Two drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. That's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
Going underneath for Crowell. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. It'll be a pickup of just two, and it'll be second down. Away to his left, and he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Try and throw on third down. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. Kenny Clark in there to drop him for a 6-yard loss, and that'll lead to a fourth down. Here's Thomas Morstead now on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. This one will wind up being down just outside of that 20-yard line. A reminder, later tonight, a game some folks have had circled on their calendars since the schedule came out in April. That's the Super Bowl rematch. Falcons, Charles, at Foxborough to take on the Patriots.
Super Bowl 51.5, anyone?
Then on Monday night, that's no slouch either, an NFC East battle between the Redskins and the Eagles. Down is Rodgers. It gets it over the middle to Kahn. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That goes for a gain of 31. Down. Here's the run to Montgomery. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that'll make it second and 12. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
They go play action here on first down. Caught left side, Bennett. And he'll go out of bounds down inside the 15-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. Second down, here's Rodgers. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Call it a 1-yard gain on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. Third down, they go Montgomery. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave them with a fourth down.
the best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Saints coming out now to take the field. And last drive, three and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that three and out on the last possession, it told you just how stalled they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's Nick Perry with a pick. And they will finally run him down, but not until he brings this one all the way back down inside the 10-yard line. You don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, two first-half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? We'll run it down with Robinson. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Denard Robinson, his first touchdown on the year. And the Packers head on to their lead. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
Yeah, that was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Around the NFL, we've got a second quarter score. And the Jaguars have scored again, so they are in the driver's seat big time in that one. And we'll keep an eye on that one as our game goes along here. Now the Saints offense, they get ready to go back to work here. And last time, one play, interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
And he's brought down after a good gain. A really nice gain of 25 yards. 21. Kill. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. Midfield, here's Breeze. Over the middle, the catch by Coleman. And they're able to get this one down to the 25. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Throwing on first down is Breeze. And that is incomplete. The target that time, Michael Thomas. That'll bring up second down.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. They're in the second quarter at Heinz Field. And the Steelers there out to an early lead. And we'll keep you abreast of how that one shakes out. On second down, here's Crowell. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10.
While there is no gain on that run, we do know coaches whose identity is rooted in taking it almost to the limit and then changing things up on you down the stretch. And we're getting really close to that point in time, though, where the identity may have to go out the window, and they've got to go a little bit faster in order to try and win the game.
Throwing now is Breeze. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. Well, at least they won't take a goose egg into intermission as they do carve out 3 points here in the waning moments of quarter number two.
Yeah, it hasn't really been the greatest of first halves. They've looked out of sync, especially on the offensive side of the ball. But a field goal here at least gives them some momentum as we tick down toward halftime.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. Give him three on the play, and that'll bring up second down. Working from the gun, Rodgers. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
You're down two touchdowns. You just know defensively, you absolutely have to come up with a big play. That nearly was one right there.
Looked over at the sideline immediately after the drop and just saw the dejection. They felt it. They thought he had it. Unfortunately, couldn't come up with it. The Packers on third down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and seven. Throwing now is Rodgers. He's got his target. It's caught. And brought down, but not before he was able to break the tackle, and the extra effort moves the sticks. And call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. So the offense has it first and 10. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. And the penalty now makes it first and 20. It's Rodgers. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Davis. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 18 yards to pick up there.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. The Packers on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This time they face a third and two. They'll run it. Here's Montgomery. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
They're in the second quarter at Heinz Field, and the Bengals out to the early advantage. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is.
And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by the Michigan man, Jake Ryan. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
They run. Montgomery takes this to the 32, maybe the 31, as the defense rallies quickly after the nice move. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Now it's Rodgers. They'll set up the screen to Montgomery. And he'll go down at the 28. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. Might have gotten this one down to the 28, and that's all. He needed two, he got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down at a yard.
Well, they picked up a portion of it, but not all that they needed. Now that leads to a decision on fourth and one. Let's see what they decide to do.
So three field goals for him here, and this last one helps him stretch out the lead.
And he's been solid as usual. And this is what you need to do. Make sure you get points out of every possession. And so far, they've done a nice job of that.
It's a very short kick taken by an up man. And they'll be set up with good field position here as he gets this up over the 40-yard line.
We all know that teams never want to use the word panic, but if they expect to win this game, it has to start right here, right now. That return just set them up for points, and it needs to be a touchdown, not a field goal.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Packer pressure, and down he goes.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
On second down, here's Breeze. Over the middle to Smith. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. First down carry now for Crowell. Calling a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. To throw is Breeze. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
The Saints on third down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. This will be third and six. Here's Breeze to throw. And he's got Heuerman. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. Breeze now on first down. That is caught at the 7-yard line. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. They come out here in the eye. Fullback try and take him home. And he tries to power forward, but he will not get back to the line of scrimmage.
After a play like that, there should be congratulations all the way around, I think, because if you can stop a big fullback like that, that's not easily done.
Yeah, he does not go down easily. You're right, but he did there. They'll try and punch it in with Crowell. And he will not only not get the yard he needed, he goes the wrong direction. Now it looks like we'll get a timeout, and we will. We've got an injured Packer on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back. They've been stuffed twice here for losses. Now it's third and goal. Closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. It's about a 3-yard pickup there, but more importantly, they're still a few yards away here. It's now fourth down and goal. On fourth down, off goes Drew Brees, and on comes the Saints kicker, Will Lutz, for the field goal attempt. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. Checking things elsewhere. Third quarter now from U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. You saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
And a nice carry there of 15 yards. Throw is Rodgers. Dancing to his left. Throw left side complete. It's Bennett. And they'll get him to the ground, but he got all the way down to the 30-yard line. He got 29 yards that time. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Handing to Montgomery. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play. And that's going to make it second and 14. Rodgers going to run the option here left. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. They'll get 4 on second down, but it leaves them with 3rd and still 9 to go.
Third quarter and you've got the lead, you're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
The Packers on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. Throwing is Rodgers. They'll roll him out right. And he's got Bennett. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. 5 yards to go for the offense. 1st down and goal from that 5-yard line. They'll come out in the pistol. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Touchdown, Packers! Lance Kendricks, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Packers add 6 to their lead. Sometimes those tight ends are a mismatch. They found the mismatch there.
And that's exactly why you want to draw up those types of plays, because coverage is just going to go to the natural guys, the guys that make the big plays on the outside. But you work your tight end into it, that's a tough one for a defense to handle.
Tough. They couldn't handle it. It worked out for six. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But we also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
No gain on that run. And while the team is down, it's still time to come back and win the football game. If I'm the offensive coordinator, though, I've got to think about moving at a faster pace and maybe opening things up a little bit and throwing it a little bit more.
Winding down. Breeze to throw on second down. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick. And it's third down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game. And to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on. And they just play better and better.
Now Breeze on third down. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Coleman. They do get 9, but it leads to fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet. Get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. Now Breeze, got to have this one. He finds Coleman. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. And they get 28 yards on that one. And it'll be first down, Saints. Some room to work. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great effort there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Saints make some inroads here to that deficit.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Breeze now to throw. And he will get into the end zone to shave 2 more points off the deficit. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. Now the return. Here comes Randall Cobb. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple of extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
They go play action here on first down. And he's taken down here by the Saints. Trey Hendrickson in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. Now Rodgers throwing on second down. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. A very solid gain of 27. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people pointed out to me, it's a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not in it.
It's caught inside the 25. That one goes for 36 yards. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
To throw, it's Rodgers. And Davis with it left side. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Now Rodgers on the bootleg. Throw right side, caught by Davis. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they can do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one.
So, Brandon, when this offense gathers together to watch tape for this game, they're going to be feeling pretty good about themselves until the coaches get upset about the play we just saw. But you know their defense is going to be. But we put up big points all game long. The defense is going to win one every now and then.
Well, he was 3 for 3 to that point, but he couldn't keep the perfect game going.
Did someone mention it on the bench and jinx
Maybe
it?
Maybe jinx him a little bit.
Well, you doubt it had anything to do with overconfidence. But, hey, it's an inexact science. These things do happen.
First and 10, here's Breeze. Being chased out left. Brought in left side by Snead. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. And some options here for the offense on second and two. Breeze now. Over the middle, complete. That's Smith. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Throwing on first down is Breeze. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll be out of bounds, able to take it down to the 40. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. Fresh set of downs here. Breeze to throw again. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Blake Martinez, and the return stops at the 39-yard line. Just a little bit of a rough stretch. 6 interceptions now in these last 2 weeks combined.
I know the easy thing is to go back to mechanics, footwork, things of that nature. I'm also wondering, is he getting fooled by what he's seeing on defense? Has the scouting report changed? Are they showing him things different than what he expected? For the second week in a row, he's throwing it to the guys in the wrong color shirts.
Yeah, he better figure, whatever the reason is, he better figure it out. They start on the ground with Robinson here. Room here to run. Denard Robinson by himself. With 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Packers add on to their lead. Checking the NFL scoreboard, they're in the fourth now in Minneapolis. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. If they hold on, a victory there would be their third of the year. Crosby on now to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well.
And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. Jake Ryan in there to take him down and to take us to the two-minute warning. Time for a break. This one, all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. Now Breeze throwing on second down. And he's going to go down again. Now you've got to hustle your guys to the line and get them set.
So, Brandon, we've sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
It's Breeze. He's going to let it fly. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's four.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. Elsewhere, they're into the fourth at Lucas Oil Stadium in Indianapolis. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. It's a 45-yard punt and eight on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. If they hold on, a victory there would be their third of the year. Rodgers looking to throw. Forced out to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
19. Rodgers will try again on second down. Caught left side by Cobb. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. The Packers on third down. They've converted three times and eight chances. This is third and seven. From midfield, here's Rodgers. Now look out, Rodgers lost the football. And this is picked up by the Saints. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line.
Well, maybe it hasn't exactly been a Rembrandt, but they've been mistake-free to this point and finally cough it up. I don't think it's going to cost them the game. They should be fine. But, boy, they're going to hate that, going back and watching tape and being able to say we were that close to achieving our goal of zero turnovers during the game.
A little blemish, but as you say, still comfortably in command. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. First down, Breeze. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Blake Martinez. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. Seven picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offensive coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
Now a handoff to start it out. Robinson. And he's going to be unable to get upfield as they take him down at the 21-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine. Second down following the run. Rodgers throwing here. Looking deep downfield. That's caught inside the 20. Oh, and the big play's going to get even bigger as penalty flags are down, and I believe they're going to get a face mask penalty tacked on. And this looks to probably be the final play. They come up in an offset eye. From the gun, it's Rodgers. And this one incomplete. Well, apparently taking a knee is not in vogue.